Brought to you by Samsonite.
On Section 3 of the News Hour tonight, where I go back to the tragedy we started the show with this evening, a tragedy which reeks of complete insensitivity and political and government apathy. A desperate father running from pillar to post in Uttar Pradesh for over a month, carrying his son's decomposing body in a wooden box, begging that an autopsy be done so that he can know the cause of his son's death and bury his own son. But instead of getting help, Munawar Khan sent from one office to the other, made to run around, travel almost in a hired truck 1,000 kilometers with his son's decomposed body. And not one politician in poll season who go from door to door seeking votes, not one authority came forward to help this father. The media reporting on the story, Times Now's coverage of the story, has led to the embarrassment, and then all of a sudden, within hours, we are told some hours back that Munawar's request was adhered to, the autopsy finally conducted. But there's a bigger story here. And on that bigger story tonight on the News Hour, I have Purnima Advani with me, former chairperson of the National Commission of Women, well-known prominent activist, Kamal Farooqi, Samajwadi Party leader, Kancha Ilaiya, well-known activist. Purnima Advani, I mean, this is ridiculous. I must say, first of all, that I think it is also ridiculous that the story actually came to the attention of the media now. But it's more ridiculous that this father was made to go from pillar to post with his son's decomposed body. I mean, this happens nowhere else.
Arnav, it's ridiculous, it's shameful, and I think the politicians and the government ought to be condemned together. The point is, I've had a similar case when I was in the commission of a pregnant woman whose child was nearly born, being rushed from one government hospital to another, and from Fatehpur Sikri she had to go all the way to Agra because there was no government doctor available. Similar is this case with poor Khan, who has to go from pillar to post with a decomposed body of his son. And when this is all because we lack political will completely in the area of forensic science and medicine. This is very crucial. It's a human rights issue. The Human Rights Commission, years ago, I think around 2001-2, has come out with formulated guidelines, rules, regulations, which need to be implemented. But where are they implemented? That's basically because the vote bank and forensic science do not go hand in hand in the eyes of political masters.
No, this is,
and
the,
that's where the sadness
the, begins. The most ridiculous thing is this, that for 25 days the body is in a mortuary. And then when the body is the authorities then say, now take the body to Lucknow, which is 300 kilometers away. When they go to Lucknow, say, go back to Jaunpur. When they go back to Jaunpur, they say, give us 5 color photographs. And by the way, we don't have an X-ray machine, so go back to Varanasi. Now, Kamal Farooqi, I thought politicians need to show some sensitivity. You're from the Samajwadi Party. Did no Samajwadi Party leader bother about Munawar's condition?
It's really shameful. As Madam has said, it's really shameful. And politics apart, but look at the human rights issue, in fact, involved into it. Any unnatural death. The people who are connected with the dead body, they have got all the rights to know the reason of the death as to what has happened to that. The relatives are, that is their fundamental right to know it. And this is the duty of the local administration to get it done immediately without any failure. This poor man, he's carrying his son's body along with him for 1 month. And these people in the administration, they have got their own interest in the administration and whatnot. Look at the hospitals. Look at the DM and the SP of the area wherein the dead body was found. They should be immediately put to task, and they should, politics or no politics,
no, they should all be sacked.
Put into such a big question.
They should all be sacked.
They must be held responsible.
No,
for
they
it.
Must be sacked. I think the Uttar Pradesh government has
they
not done
safe.
Enough.
Yes, I agree with you.
It has not done enough because, you know, they are very embarrassed now. So they quickly carried out the postmortem and they want to hush up this case. The Mayawati government must sack all the officials involved in this case. Right? Purnima Advani, you second that? Not enough.
But Arnav, the point is they are sacked today, but the very purpose of the postmortem is not going to be achieved because that body has undergone a process of decomposition. What could have been determined in the first initial hours is not going to be possible today. On the one hand, our country still faces a criminal justice system where you have to prove every point beyond a reasonable doubt. And on the other hand, unfortunately, because of lack of political will, our investigative system is such that there are doubts creeping in at every stage because of the kind of problems that you have brought forth today. So irrespective of sacking they must. But irrespective of that, we have lost the entire damages imposed on Mayawati government.
I'm asking a very basic question here. Kancha Ilaiya, in your view, is there any defense of something as outrageous as this?
No, Arnab, see, where is the defensive for such a...
No, because you are usually very supportive of the Mayawati government. But in this case, I'm sure...
The question is that, look at the whole sequence here. If the boy was killed in some accident or somebody killed him, the identity was not established, if he was put in mortuary for so many days... Now, naturally, the police and the medical system would have done postmortem of that, and the cause would have been established then and there whether the parents are identified or not. That is number one. And those people, hospital people, should be immediately the superintendent of that hospital where the postmortem, the body was kept for so many days, has to be suspended. The police of that area, superintendent of police, must be suspended. And when the body was brought to Lucknow, how they could send it back?
Exactly.
Again saying that, we can't do it, they must be suspended. The Human Rights Commission must step in and the health minister must be sacked straight away. I mean, whether Mayawati intervenes or not, this is not the merely question of the election, This is the whole question.
Look at the tragedy that poor man was not even allowed the normal x-ray. The government is totally failure on this, because we have seen scam after scam in this medical field, hospitals after hospitals. We have seen 3 murders. It shows that there is a link between all these kind of things, and the people have become so powerful in the whole system that they don't care about the human value. It is shameful. It is so shameful. And madam,
I agree with you.
Right. Some serious action has to be taken against
the Mayawati
government about it, because
she's
responsible for it.
No, you see,
whosoever is the chief minister.
Let me tell you from my heart. From my heart, I don't want to politicize this. Believe me, I don't want to politicize this. But I must ask the question that in which other country, Kancha Ilaiya, you often speak about social indices, development, the great work Mayawati is doing. In which other country do officials...
You have a father who's
carrying his son's body for hundreds of kilometers, decomposed body. He's put it in a gunny bag, put that gunny bag in a box, and he's going and begging at the Lucknow hospital, please just conduct an autopsy, so I want to bury my son. And they say, come back with 5 photographs and x-ray reports. I mean, this is insensitivity.
The point is that whoever is the chief minister, we cannot just come to a conclusion that the chief minister knew about it and or deliberately has made the father to go around like this. I mean, jumping conclusion to whoever is the chief minister, that is not possible in a state like that. The point is, how is it that the institutional structures that got established from the lower rung upwards functioned in this inhuman manner?
I take you.
Having come to know what Mayawati is going to do tomorrow, I think is certainly an issue. I certainly agree with you.
I think
that having come to know what is that she is going to do, whether election or no election,
I am asking a question today.
I see the point.
Please, Purnima Advani, one second. Let Purnima Advani come in. Purnima Advani, yes.
Arnav, if Mayawati fails to penalize the persons who are who are culpable. It would give a completely incorrect message to the masses that this is the highest degree of insensitivity any government is capable of demonstrating to the public. They have no business to remain in office.
Yeah.
It requires a very high degree of insensitivity to be able to have this kind of conduct, that a father goes from pillar to post carrying the dead body and ruins of his sons. I mean, there must be prompt action, and
Kamal Farooqi
of Mayawati needs to be publicized. Action or otherwise, whichever way it is.
I simply raise one question, and please, I am not politicizing the whole thing. Look at the system. This man, why Mayawati was not in a position to, you have been in a position to know it. You are tracking this story for so many days.
No.
I am following it up. How come a chief minister is not in a position to know this human tragedy?
I must say,
she is keeping quiet.
Last year.
Tomorrow she will sack.
Last year.
But what is...
No, my question is, my simple question is, I think, and I'm saying this genuinely, as a media person, I myself feel embarrassed that the media is picking up the story now. This man's has been going through this for 1.5 months. I'm asking, where are the politicians in UP when they go around asking for votes, dividing it, asking for caste lines, polarization, who's going to do what, who's going to cut what deal, who's going to do a deal with which party? Why did they not think of Munawar is my only question tonight, and we'll follow the story where it goes. To my esteemed guest, thank you very much. And to all the viewers of News Hour tonight, with a promise to follow stories that really matter. I'll be back tomorrow. Good night and goodbye.